Hey there! Today I'm going to show you how you can access your Home Assistant server through SSH, which means that you can type in commands on your local computer as if you were on your Home Assistant server. And that helps in installing things like HACS, for example. So let's dive into this. Sometimes you need to execute commands on your Home Assistant server. You can do that by connecting your Raspberry Pi or your Home Assistant server to a monitor and a keyboard and type in the commands that you want to execute. But it's much more easier to type it in on your local machine as if you were on Home Assistant server yourself. You can do that with SSH, and it's really simple to set up, but for people who start with this, it might be a bit tricky, so I'm going to show you how that works. So let's dive into it. For that, we go to the supervisor in Home Assistant. So I click on supervisor and you see the add-on store in supervisor. And in the add-on store, there are a lot of add-ons that you can install. And the one that we are searching for is the SSH add-on. And this is the one that you want, the SSH and web terminal add-on. This is the Home Assistant community add-on. So if you open that, you can install it. I've got it already installed, but there's an install button normally here, and you can just install it and wait for it to be installed. After that, you have to go into the configuration to configure this thing. So there's the configuration. So click on configuration and you can see you can enter all kinds of information here. There are three important things to enter here. That is a username. So for me, it's now a Smart Home Junkie, and then a password, which is unique enough, because if it's not really unique, it won't start the add-on, and your authorized keys. Well, for the authorized keys, that might be a challenge for some people, how that works. And I'm going to show you how you can create an authorized key. Basically, what this key does is that it detects that you are a person that is authorized to go to this server through SSH. So for this, I'm on Windows here. On a Mac, it works sort of the same, and on Linux, it works also the same. We have to create an SSH key. So for that, I'm going to my command line. So I have the command prompt here. And I'm going to create an SSH key. And you can do that with the following command, SSH-key. So now it's going to ask me where to put this key. You can just put enter here. So it's going to my home folder with subfolder.ssh/id_RSA. In my case, it's already there, so it's asking me to override it, but I think in your case it might not be there. So if it's there, don't override it and use the one that you already have, because maybe you use that key for something else. So, but I'm going to override it now, just to show you what happens. Then it asks me for a passphrase, and I leave it empty. It is less secure, but it's more convenient for me. So I'm leaving it empty, empty, empty again. And now it is created. And I can find my public key in this folder. So if I go here to that folder, so that is cd.ssh. I ask for the directory, I see this file here, id_rsa.pub. So how do I get into this file? Well, I'm taking the easy route here, so I'm going back to search and type in notepad. So notepad opens, and now I'm going to open this file in notepad. So I'm going to open, and I go to this PC, local disk C, users, my case add.ssh, and now it says it doesn't see any files, but that's because it's just looking for text documents. So I'm changing this to all files, and here it is. So I open this, and this is the key. So it's quite a long string, as you can see here. I'm just going to copy this, copy, and now I'm going back to my Home Assistant configuration of my SSH and web terminal, and I'm going to add the authorized key here. I already had a authorized key here, so I'm going to add a new one. So basically it's enough to just put a dash and then paste it. So let's get rid of the space over there. And now I'm going to save this. The add-on is asking me to restart it, so I restart the add-on. And now this one is here. I am going to remove my old one because that was the old one for the same machine. But you probably don't have to do that. So save it again, restart add-on. And now I can check in my log if the add-on has been started correctly. So if I go down here, refresh to ensure, logging in, starting Home Assistant, starting. Okay, so it is started. If there was something wrong, you should get an error here, and then you did something wrong in your configuration. So how can I now access my Home Assistant server through SSH? For that, I'm going back to my command prompt and I'm going to type in SSH and then the username that I had here, so Smart Home Junkie. Well, let's just copy the password for my convenience. Copy. And I know my Home Assistant is at a certain IP address, but I'm going to first type Smart Home Junkie, which is my username, at, and then the IP address at which my Home Assistant resides. So that's 192.168.168.132. I know it's here. Probably you already know on what IP address your Home Assistant is. If not, look into your router and you can see it. I press enter. And now it's going to ask me to add this IP address to a known hosts file. Forget it, just type yes. And I'm in there. And I'm in there without logging in because it recognized my authorized key. If it doesn't do that, you have to enter your password. So then it will ask you for a password. Sometimes it asks for passwords, sometimes not. And now I am on Home Assistant, on my Home Assistant server. So I can use Linux commands to look into the files of my Home Assistant server. So one of the Linux commands is ls. And if I do ls or ls minus la, and I see all the files which are here. But I also can enter different commands here to install things, and you sometimes need that. So this is how you get into your Home Assistant server through SSH. Just one more thing. If you go to the info tab of the SSH and web terminal add-on, there is an option show in sidebar. See, that is this option, show in sidebar. And if you click it, then it shows you the terminal also in the sidebar, and you can click here and you get directly into the Home Assistant SSH console. You can also see that it shows here Home Assistant help. So if I type HA help, I get all the commands that I can use in Home Assistant. And for instance, what I can do is I can restart Home Assistant with this command. So what I can do is, for instance, HA core and then type restart, and then it will restart my Home Assistant. So I can restart it this way too. I'm not going to do that. So this is an easy way to install SSH for your Home Assistant server, and you can use it to install all kinds of other things into Home Assistant, which is more advanced but sometimes needed, for instance for installing HACS the new way. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, give it a thumbs up, like my video, share the video, and don't forget to subscribe, tick the little bell, and I see you next time. Bye bye.